Students, in this session we are going to discuss about deadlock. So consider one scenario. There are two processes P1 and P2, and each process accessing one resource. For example, P1 process accessing a resource A and P2 process accessing a resource B. At the same time, P1 process wait for the resource B and P2 process wait for the resource A. So this is a scenario for deadlock situation. When this situation occurs, the program cannot go further. Okay, it hangs. It's about infinite time. Okay, this is the situation. Now the task before the operating system is how this deadlock will come and how identify this deadlock and how rectify this deadlock. Okay, so this is a system model. Generally in a system there are number of processes available and each process use certainly a resource. Without a resource a process cannot do anything. So every process needs or utilize a resource. How it utilizes? First it requests the resource, then it uses the resource, after that it releases the resource. That means maybe sometimes one process requests a resource, at that time other process also come start the request to the same resource. Okay, and after the request, once request granted, the resource is allocated to the particular process, then the process use the resource. So finally after completion of the work of the process, then the process release the resource. This is normal system model. Now the question is, we know what is deadlock, but how deadlock comes? So deadlock comes either the four conditions, any of the four conditions or all the conditions occurs, then we can say that there is a deadlock situation will definitely occur. What are those? The first one is mutual exclusion, hold and wait, no preemption, circular wait. So mutual exclusion means, suppose a resource is allocated to a process, after completion of the work of the process on the resource, no other process enters or getting access of the resource. That is called mutual exclusion. Suppose one process gets the usage of one resource, the process using that resource, at that time any request occurs for the resource from another process, the process should wait until the completion of the first process. This is called mutual exclusion. When one resource is allocated to one process, no other process enters into that resource. This is called mutual exclusion. Next one is hold and wait. Means if one process holding one resource, that means one process using the services of one resource and waiting for another resource. If that situation occurs, we may expect the deadlock will come. And no preemption. Preemption means the resource is allocated to the process, but if any high priority process or whatever another process is coming or requesting the resource, the operating system cannot preempt that resource. In that situation also deadlock will occur. And circular wait. So whatever the example given earlier, circular wait, if there are more than one process, 2, 3, 4, one process holding one resource waiting for another resource which is occupied by some other process, like that if it is a chain, that is called circular wait. If there is a circular wait, definitely there will be a deadlock. Okay, so any of these conditions or all the conditions occurs in a program, we can say that there will be definitely a deadlock will occur. Now we will discuss resource allocation graph. So the resource allocation graph is the graphical representation of the process and the resources and their requests. Okay, why we go for resource allocation graph means, using resource allocation graph we can identify whether deadlock will occur or not. In the resource allocation graph, we use certain graphical elements. Those are process, resource, request edge, and assignment edge. And the processes are identified by using circles, resources are identified by using squares, request edge and assignment edge is a arrow symbols. So if one direction we can say that it is a request edge, in opposite direction we can say that assignment edge. Now we can observe. So there is a process. Process is denoted by using a circle. Resource type is allocated by using a square. Within the square there are again small boxes that tells the instances of the resource. Maybe one resource is allocated to one process, and if it is shared resource, that is allocated to multiple process. So here multiple instances are there, okay. And if you observe, this is a process. Process directs to resource. This is called P request instance of resource. That means here process is requesting the resource. Process is requesting the resource. Process is waiting or seeing for the resource. And if you observe the next one, process, and arrow comes to the process from the square, from the resource. That means this resource is allocated to the process. So the first one is process is requesting the resource for getting the access, and second one is resource is assigned to the process. So by using these notations we can draw the resource allocation graph. This is an example of the resource allocation graph. Here three processes are there, P1, P2, P3, and P1 requesting the resource R1, and R1 assigned to the resource P2, and again P2 requesting the resource R3, R3 assigned for P3. Here R2 is one resource having multiple instances, and one instance it is assigning to the P1 and another instance is assigning to the P2. So R2 having R4 having three instances, but it is ideal. Okay, this is one example. Now we will see another example. See here also, P1 requesting R1, R1 is assigned to P2, P2 requesting R3, R3 is assigning to P3, P3 requesting R2, R2 is assigned to P1, and also one instance is assigned to P2. So if you compare both previous allocation graph and this, in this resource allocation graph you can identify one cycle. We can identify one cycle. So P1 to R1, R1 to P2, P2 to R3, R3 to P3, P3 to R2, R2 to P1. If after drawing the resource allocation graph, if the graph contains any cycle like this, then we can say that definitely there is a deadlock situation. So resource allocation graph is used to identify whether the deadlock will come or not, and identify the deadlock. Okay. So next, methods for handling deadlocks. So there are certain methods, we name it as different names. So deadlock prevention, deadlock avoidance, deadlock detection, so like that. In that, first we discussed on prevention of the deadlock. How you can prevent the deadlock? Prevention of the deadlock means through software we can implement certain protocols, based on that you can prevent the deadlock. Or else if you have the information regarding the process and the resource and the request and the demands and all, we can develop a resource allocation graph. Based on that we can identify the deadlock situation occur or not. This is the prevention. Okay. See, to ensure the deadlock never occur, the system can use either a deadlock prevention or a deadlock avoidance scheme. Okay. So deadlock prevention. So deadlock prevention means, here we know that there are four situations. Those situations, if any single situation or more than one situation is there in your program or a process, then definitely there will be a deadlock. What are those four? Mutual exclusion, hold and wait, no preemption, and circular wait. If you avoid these, suppose you are writing one program, that program may generate multiple process, and that program having the resources which are shareable to the different process. While writing the program, so you thought about the mutual exclusion property, hold and wait, no preemption, and circular wait. If you avoid these kinds of algorithms, so definitely you can prevent the deadlock. Okay. Next, deadlock avoidance. Avoidance means definitely before starting your program, you need further information, some extra information regarding the process and the resources, so that you can easily draw the resource allocation graph and you can identify the deadlock. Suppose if there is deadlock occurs while you are running the program, even though there is a deadlock occurs, simply you can ignore the deadlock or you can kill the process and again restart the deadlock. So this is about what is deadlock and when deadlock will, what are the characteristics of deadlock, when the deadlock will come, and what is the significance of the resource allocation graph, and what are the different techniques to prevent, to avoid, and to detect the deadlock mechanisms. Okay, thank you.